So I was up pretty late last night getting these posts right here screwed into this garden bed. And I got these from Lowe's. I want to say they were like $8 a piece when I got them. They may be more now because that was pre-COVID. And all I did was they have a spear on the ends and I just pushed them into the ground and then screwed one screw in each bottom of each post into the bed and then brought them together and screwed them on top. And underneath the triangles, I'm going to run a post all the way across to connect them and make them sturdy. And it actually has wire and you can see my tomatoes. They've gotten really tall, so what I did was I kind of weaved them through the wire. That way it gives them some support. Now, eventually, our truck's broke down right now. When it's fixed, we're going to get some cattle panel and put it up both sides, and that's going to give it a really sturdy area for all of our blackberries and tomatoes to grow. Now, next year, we probably won't plant tomatoes here because we did plant blackberries, and those are perennials, but this year, I got those tomatoes in long before I even thought I wanted blackberries. So, and here's kind of an up close. It's really hard to see, but you can see the wire. I just screwed, I just put some 1-inch screws into here and attached the wire to it that way. And it's really easy, guys. I'm not a super strong or super tall woman. You know, I'm 5'4". A little over 5'4", you know, so I can do this myself. You guys can definitely do it. If you have some upper body strength, which I am severely lacking in because I've got COVID lazy before I started really gardening again, then you can do this. You can do this by yourself. It is really simple. I was out here by myself with a light on doing it at midnight last night. And look at this, man. This is one of my black creme tomatoes. And I'm just so impressed by it. I'm saving it for my son to come and pick it because he really loves it. But he hasn't. So let me go around and show you how tall this is and all the blossoms on it. And of course, I stepped in some wire that I didn't clean up last night. So it's important to clean your workspace. Which I rarely do. Look at these. Aren't those beautiful? I'm so excited that there are so many tomatoes coming like this, you know, and they're basically, they're trimmed back, you know. I didn't trim them back to one stem, but it's basically growing from one stem. There are not a lot of foliage, but they're producing pretty well. So hopefully, you know, these are just little transplants that I bought from the local grocery store, and now they're as tall as I am, or up to above my waist. So that's pretty exciting, and it actually looks like these are catching up. And so I posted a video yesterday that the cats are actually getting here and using the bathroom. So what I'm going to do is right along the edge of this bed, I actually got some grid wire, which we call it predator wire down here. I'm not sure what people call it everywhere else because I've heard so many different names for it. But it's little 1x1 squares, and I'm going to line it along the bottom of this bed, just like staple it into the wood. So hopefully that keeps them from getting in here and just destroying everything. I showed yesterday, I want to show you again because they've already grown right in here. There are little baby cantaloupes, and I'm so excited. If you know me, then you know I've had the worst luck. There's actually a little spider web right here. So that's exciting because that means that spider's going to be catching all these bugs. I have not had a problem with aphids, guys, but I was looking, like, we have fire ants everywhere, and they've been driving me crazy. Like, look at this. There are fire ants in this bed. And so I reach my hand in there and sometimes I get ants, but I have not had a single aphid. And I was reading last night and it turns out that these crazy fire ants actually like harvest aphids, especially off these okra plants. Aphids are a huge and one of the main and only pests on okra, besides maybe some worms because they do like to eat the munch on the leaves during early summer. But that's pretty much it. And I haven't had an aphid issue at all. That's the one pest I have not seen. Look at this, is another black crimp tomato, and man, it's getting... This one's a younger transplant that I just did not think was going to make it, and just shot up. So, I'm all for the fire ant sting. I know that sounds crazy, but, I mean, man, I don't know what this is. I think it's a turnip, guys, because getting a root. Turnips are don't do well down here during summer. Like, this is definitely a winter crop. Not even a fall crop, but a late fall winter crop here because of how hot it is. Wow. That just blows my mind because a lot of the turnips and stuff I planted during winter died because we had a freeze. Like, literally, the water in my toilet bowl froze during this freeze. So, I'm just, like, in shock. But I really want to get out here and show you the new trellis on the garden bed and kind of what we were doing. I thought it was so fascinating. Good morning, Sammy. My little boy stayed the night with his grandfather last night in their home, and I'm so excited. Okay, so let me walk over here, and I'll show you the garden bed we were working on yesterday. Look how good it looks. This is the one we were putting the newspaper down in to get ready to mulch, and wow. It turned out so well. Now I just need to change some of the siding on the house and paint it. And I'm actually going to go ahead and make a video when we do that and show off. We have some marigolds, some lemongrass, and a little zinnia. And I love zinnias. They are so pretty.
Actually, they are.
They are. And marigolds are probably one of our all-time favorite flowers for our household. They are said to bring peace and comfort and ward off bad intentions and people with bad intentions. And man, do they bring peace and comfort. My husband said, well, baby, you probably should have got like 3 more keys and some marigolds. Look at this. I've had this. I actually bought it from HEB, which is the local grocery store, a couple months ago. And I transplanted like 4 or 5 of them. But I haven't transplanted this one. But look at all these goji berries. They're not ready. And so, for those of you who haven't had a goji berry, they're more like for medicinal purposes. They're really, really good for you. I recommend cooking them with some sugar, maybe some pies, throw them in cookies that have a ton of sugar. I grabbed a handful of goji berries once and ate it, and it was the worst mistake I've ever made in my life. And I wish I would have done it before, before I went and bought all these goji berries. Look at these flowers. This is what the other bed started off as. It didn't have a brick border. It was just, I planted flowers that do really well, mostly annuals here, that do well here in our clay soil. And then I came back, laid down newspaper, and laid down mulch. Now with the newspaper, you gotta make sure you wet it, because if not, the wind will catch it. It'll just start flying away before you're even done laying it down. It's really frustrating. This is sorrel. Guys, and you can eat it, and does so well. This doesn't do well because I've just transplanted and haven't watered it in because I suck. I don't really have a good excuse. But I grabbed a mouthful of sorrel. I grabbed it, and I was like, oh, I want to try the sorrel. I've never tried it. And I picked it, and I shoved it in my mouth, and it was so sour. It's like eating the 3-leaf clovers with the purple flowers. That's exactly what it was like, and it was so sour. This is bee balm, and I really like it. I've never seen bee balm in bloom in my yard. I have a couple of bee balm plants, and I'm just like waiting impatiently. This is actually here before the garden bed.
Mom, what was
bee balm? Is a really pretty flower.
Yeah,
and it's also used as a type of medicine. Oh, look at this. Yeah. This is another zinnia. It's just little baby zinnias. Guys, did you know that there are several species of flies that actually pollinate flowers? Look at that. And mosquitoes actually pollinate too. The only time that mosquitoes drink blood is when the females are breeding and they need to lay eggs. They're actually a major pollinator. There are so many things that we don't think of as pollinators that are. Look at this sorrel. It looks so bad. It looks like it's almost... gonna die. I need to come out here and water these in. It's a really bad idea not to water your plants in. Here's another goji, and it's growing pretty wild, but look at that. There's some berries on it, and I'm pretty excited about that. And look, this is my coneflower. It is my pride and joy. Guys, coneflowers...
I bought that, Mom.
Yeah, my Sam bought it for me. And coneflowers are actually my favorite flower. And they're really good for stomach aches, inflammation, and various other problems that you may have. And you can make tea out of them. I think this is one of the most powerful medicines and the most gorgeous flowers. And it's really sturdy. The tops of it are actually really spiky, but they're not painful. So they do really well. And it's one of my favorite flowers. And I think the swamp sunflower, which are the sunflowers you see growing wild all over the place. Look at my dog. He's eating my marigolds, guys. He is literally eating a marigold. I'm pretty sure French marigolds are poisonous. You cannot eat a French marigold. Sugar, stop. Stop it.
You can
eat Kanjula, which is a different type of marigold. It's more like a saucer flower. But you should not be eating French marigolds. Guys, I didn't know that at first. Look at my fig. I finally have a fig. I'm so excited. I am so excited about that. You cannot eat French marigolds. I did not know that at first. And I planted a ton of French marigolds. And then I started doing research on how to harvest it. And imagine my surprise when I just spent all this money on certain marigolds that I thought were edible. And they were not. Now, they are good at warding off pests. I plant them around our bean trellis. And believe it or not, it kind of attracted stuff more to them. And so that did work. And look at this. We have another one. Oh, yes. My tomatillos. I'm so excited. I literally came out here and turned around and was like, oh, there's a tomatillo for me. And they formed the giant husk before the husk tomato is actually even really big enough. They start off like this, super tiny. Little flowers, and they turn into tiny husks. Maybe they don't want to watch it. Maybe they do. This is another one of our muscadine grapevines, and my ideas in this space is to get like a big arbor. That way we can sit on it and let the grapevines grow over it, and then as it gets more mature, it'll shade us and the grapes will just drop through. And that could just be me having a lot of wishes and never work, but hey. No, I'm not done. This kid just wants to play on my phone. He spent the night at his grandfather's house, and now all he can think about is, I want to play a game on Mom's phone. What if someone else had the phone when I wasn't here? I'm just giving you a quick overview. Not a lot of in-depth here, because I've done so many videos. Look at this. San Marzano tomatoes are where it's at. This is probably, like, one of my top five. And after this year, it's probably my number one tomato plant. I mean, look at this. It's just, wow. Guys, these are supposed to be indeterminate plants, but they're actually pretty rigid. You know, you do have to watch them because when they set fruit, they set in clusters and it gets kind of heavy. Look at clusters. But they do really, really well here. I am so impressed. Nothing does better than my parsley, though. Look at that. This is curly leaf Italian parsley. Oh my gosh. It smells good. It tastes good. It's a staple. Look at that. That chocolate mint is just taking over the bed. I'm hoping, honestly, I'm fine if it spreads over the entire bed. Having too much chocolate mint is not a thing. And then here are the very carrots that I posted when I said eat your root veggie tops, that they are edible and they actually taste like cilantro. And look, they are getting so big. And the crazy thing is it's summertime. I just threw them out here because the seeds were not taken care of. They were several years old and just thrown in a drawer somewhere and forgotten. So I figured throw them out there or they're just going to go in the trash anyway.
No.
Look at that flower. Look at my salvia. This is Mystic Salvia. Salvia is actually a type of mint, and it's actually seeding, you know. It was all nice and had its leaves, and now it's going to seed. It's just that time of year. Everything's going to seed and preparing for next season. And most of this will come back. It'll go to seed and I'll immediately start regrowing because of the heat here. And so, and then it'll cool down just in time and then I'll be able to harvest it. Mwah, my baby Sam. Oh, this rose. This is my tea rose and boy, Sugar, get back over here. Is it the most beautiful peach tea rose I've ever seen? I'm so in love with it. This is a compact rose, so it's not going to get super tall. Probably like 2 foot by 2 to 4 feet, but it's amazing. I actually have a climbing rose now, and I'm super excited to see what happens with my climbing rose. Now, my husband doesn't want me to put my climbing rose on the house because he doesn't want it to climb underneath the siding of the house. And I can't even lie and say that I wouldn't let that happen because I have a bad habit of letting things get away from me and getting overwhelmed. Because I get bored, so I keep planning and planning until suddenly I'm overwhelmed. This is a store-bought bok choy, guys. I cut it off at the base, we ate it, and then I put it in the ground. And so it's actually doing it. It's growing, even though it's summertime. So we'll see what happens. It actually had flowers in the middle of it, so I wouldn't be surprised if it tries to go to seed fairly quickly. But we're trying it out. These are some strawberries, and I'm really hoping that they actually just propagate all over here and just trail out and cover too. And believe it or not, like, my favorite thing is strawberry and mint and lemonade. It may sound weird, that and strawberry basil lemonade, when you specifically use the sweet basil, and if you want something with a little spice, try Thai basil, because I'm telling you, like, there's nothing like the kick of Thai basil. But sweet basil, these sweet basil leaves with some lemonade and strawberries is amazing. So, all right, well, I'm gonna get off here and go do everything that I need to do today, but that kind of gives you an overview of what we've been up to here. And then tomorrow, my sister has requested that
You have the phone about me?
I teach her how to cut and propagate hydrangeas, so I'll probably go ahead and make a video. That way, for one, she can follow it and see everything going on. And for two, so that anyone else who wants to cut hydrangeas and propagate them will see how. So thank you for joining us, and I hope you have a blessed and amazing day.